Welcome to first PU online classes. Right, today we will discuss a very very important theorem that is called as a work. Here very very important theorem that is called as a work energy theorem. This is, we are discussing the two cases. Very very important here. Listen. First, we are discussing in case of a constant force. First, what is the statement of the work energy theorem? Work done by a force on a body. Is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body. This is statement. Now, how to say this statement, what is there in the mathematical form? Now, work done is equal to change in the kinetic energy. Means kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial. KEF meaning is kinetic energy final. KEI meaning is what is there, kinetic energy initial. Is equal to change in the kinetic energy. That is called as a final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy is called as change in the kinetic energy. This is a statement of the what is here, work energy theorem. Work done by a force on a body is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body. That can be written as W is equal to kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial is equal to delta K. This is we are defining, first I am deriving in case of constant force. Next we can derive in case of variable force also. Right, statement is same for the both. Statement is what is here, work done by a force. This is called as a work done by a force is equal to the change in the kinetic energy. Of the body means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. That is called as a change in the kinetic energy. That is we are written as a delta K. Right. Now first we are given the here what is the statement. Now next to here we can, what is the proof of the this kinetic, here what is your work energy theorem, this is a statement here. Now what is the proof we can make here? Next to here, this is the first I am writing just mathematical form here. Here this is the statement. First we know that here what is your, what next to we can make the proof of the this here, what is your work energy theorem. Already we are writing mathematical form. What is we are writing here? Kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial is equal to delta K. We are written. Now we can prove this one. Listen here. Here this is a block of mass M. Yeah. The kinetic energy also we have discussed the same. On this block of mass, I am applying a force F. Now it displaces through a distance. Yes. Means force and displacement both are in the same direction. Now displaces through a distance. Yes. Here this block having the initial velocity I am taken as a U. There is in the kinetic energy expression, their body is at rest position. Here body is moving with initial velocity U. When body is moving initial velocity u, now on this body I am applying the force F. it is accelerates means its velocity, final velocity is becomes vv. And is accelerate means its velocity can be changes initial velocity to final velocity. Here first the body is in the motion, on this body I am applying the force. Listen, the kinetic energy, what is here? The kinetic energy expression derivation, we consider that initially the body at rest position. Here body, initially the body at motion, it is moving with velocity u. On this body I am applying the force F. It will be accelerated, means its velocity can be changes. Initial velocity is the u, final velocity is the v. First of all I am writing here initial kinetic energy of the body. Initial kinetic energy of the body I am writing here K E I. Initial kinetic energy of the body I am writing as a kinetic energy initial is equal to half m u square. This is initial kinetic energy of the body because initial velocity is u. Next I am writing as a final kinetic energy of the body KEF, that is can be written as half m v square. This is the initial kinetic energy, this is the final kinetic energy. From next to from or according to Newton's second law, according to Newton's second law, what we know that according to Newton's second law F equal to ma, this is a here this is given to equation number 1, this is given to equation number 2, this is given to equation number 3, right? This is according to Newton's second law we are writing here. From here next to this is we are written from equation number 3, this is from according to Newton's second law. Now next I am writing here next to next we are taken as a here from kinematics equation. From kinematics equation what we know that from the kinematic equation v square minus u square is equal to 2as, right? Now 2as is equal to v square minus u square. Okay, from this a is equal to v square minus u square by 2s, we are getting this one. Now next to here this is a value, this is given to equation number 4. Here equation 4 substitute in equation 3 we get. Now I am writing here this is F is equal to m into v. A value, A value is equal to what we know that here v square minus u square by 2s, right? Clear? Now here next this is given to equation number 5. Next I am writing here work done by the force, work done by the force, you know that formula W is equal to F S cos theta. But the body is displaced in the same direction of the force, theta is equal to 0 degrees, so F S cos 0. Now W is equal to what we are getting here, Fs into 1 is equal to Fs. Now work done is equal to Fs. Now this is given to equation number 6. Now I am making here, this is now remaining here, what is here equation 6, what is here equation 5 substituting equation 6. I am removing this one. Here this is a equation Here what is here? 6. Equation 5. Equation 5 substitute in equation 6. We get. Now what we are getting here? This is W is equal to here F in the place of the F, I am writing M into V square minus Q square by 2S into what is here S. Here S is getting cancer. Here S is getting cancer means here what we are getting, we are remaining. Now I am writing as a W is equal to, now remaining I am written as a mv square minus mu square by 2. S is getting cancer. Now this equation 5 substituting in equation 6. Now what is we are getting? W is equal to m into v square minus u square by 2 s into s. Now what is getting here? W is equal to S is getting cancer. M multiplying this one, mv square. M multiplying this one, m u square by 2. Now 2 is separating both. Now this is what is there, half m v square. This is minus half m u square. We know that already. This is we are written in the equation 1. Equation 2, this is written as final kinetic energy. This is called as a initial kinetic energy. The equation 1 and 2 we are written already. This is a initial kinetic energy, this is a final kinetic energy. So what we are getting here from this, we have final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Here the final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy is called as a change in the kinetic energy. Right, this is a, what is here, we are getting the same statement of the, what is here, work energy theorem. What is the work energy theorem statement here? The work done by the force is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body. Change in the kinetic energy of the body means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. This is the, what is here, work energy theorem for which force here? Constant force. Right, simply here also same. Here body is initially it is having the velocity u. Here final velocity is v. Now the force F is equal to, we are written as a ma, first equation. Now that is the kinematic equation we are using here. V square minus u square is equal to 2as. Here 2as is equal to v square minus u square. A is equal to v square minus u square by v square minus u square by 2s. Now equation 4, substituting equation 3, that is the equation 3 is equal to, already know that F is equal to ma. That is we are substituting in the equation 3, nothing but F is equal to ma. F is equal to m into a value is equal to v square minus u square by 2s. Now here this is the F value we are getting here. Work done by the force I am writing here. W is equal to Fs cos theta. Here theta is 0 degrees because force and displacement both are in the same direction. So Fs cos 0, W is equal to Fs into 1. So W is equal to Fs. Now this equation 5 I am substituting in equation 6. Now equation 5 substituting in equation 6 we get here W is equal to m into v square minus u square by 2s into s. This is I am writing in the place of the F, I am writing this value. S is getting cancelled. Here m multiplying this one, m v square, m u square separately multiplying by 2. Here separately divided with 2 here. Now half m v square minus half m u square. Half mv square already written in the equation 1. What is written? Final kinetic energy. Half mu square is called as a initial kinetic energy. This is represents the final kinetic energy. This is represents the initial kinetic energy. This change is represents what is here? Delta k. This delta k is called as a change in the kinetic energy. From this we are saying that what is the statement of the work energy theorem? Work done by a force on the body is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body. This is the proof of the, what is here, work energy theorem. This is for which force here? Constant force. Next to today again we will discuss the next to what is here, work energy theorem for variable force also we will discuss here. same. Here this is for work energy theorem for which force here? Variable force. Right, clear? Now work energy theorem for the variable force. Now same statement. Here same statement is what is here? Work done by a force. Same statement. Work done by a force is equal to change in the kinetic energy. Change in the kinetic energy means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy is equal to delta K. Delta K is called as a change in the kinetic energy. Same the words also you can write down. In the same words you can write down here. Work done by the force is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body. Work done by the force on the body is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body. The mathematical form is W is equal to kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial is equal to delta K. Listen here. Now suppose I am considered our body. On this body, I am applying the what is their force F. It displaces through a small distance ds. Displaces through a small distance I am consider, that is ds. Now its initial velocity is u. Final velocity is v. This body is having the mass m. It is displaces through a small distance ds. Its initial velocity is u. Final velocity is v. Now on this body I am applying the forces F. Now when displaces through a small distance ds, here small work is done. That small work done I am written as a body is displaced through a small distance. Now I am making the proof here. Now this is I am consider as a body. Here on this body I am applying the force F. Now it is displaces through a small distance ds in the direction of the force. Its initial velocity is u, final velocity is v. In this case, I am writing as a work done. How to write the work done? I am writing here. Now, work done can be written as a force into displacement. Force into displacement. Here, force and displacement both are in the which direction? Same direction is a. That is a small displacement is a. So we are writing a small work done. That small work done I am writing here. Now what is I am writing here? Small work done dw is equal to, or you can draw the diagram also here. This is what is here. This is block of mass m. I am applying the force F. It is displaces to a small distance is same block we have considered. It displaces to a small distance ds. Ds is a small distance of ds. Its initial velocity is u, final velocity is v. Okay. Now in this small work done, I am writing dw is equal to f ds cos theta. Here theta is 0 degrees because force and displacement both are in the same direction. Now dw is equal to f ds cos 0. Now dw is equal to f into ds into 1. Now dw is equal to f into ds. Right, this is we are writing as a small. What is here? Work done. Dw is equal to F into ds. Now listen. This dw is equal to force. Force I am written as a mass into acceleration into ds. F is equal to ma. Okay. Now dw is equal to mass into acceleration means a change in the velocity dv by dt. You have written in the motion in a straight line chapter also. A is equal to what is here? dv by dt. Change in the velocity with respect to time. dv by dt into ds. Right? The place of the A I am written as A. Here what is here? A is equal to dv by dt. A is equal to I am written as a dv by dt. Right? That is the A value here. This A value I am written as A. Acceleration A is equal to dv by dt. Okay. Now, dw is equal to m into, listen here. This is dt applying to ds. dv, dv writing as is what? This is I am writing like this, ds by dt, there is no change in the value. This is dt applying to ds. In the multiplication is x, so I am directly changing it. M into dv into ds by dt. Clearly this earlier, this step is very very important. We are making the mistakes here. M into dv by dt into ds. dv into this dt I am applying to ds. Now this is called as a change in the displacement. Change in the displacement is called as velocity with respect to time. Now change in the displacement with respect to time is called as a velocity. Now this is I am written as a dw is equal to m dv into v. ds by dt can be written as a v. Now dw is equal to m v into dv. Right, this is a small work done. Now next to total work done, when the body is displacing total distance s, the total work done I am written as a total work done. In order to find the total work done in physics, we have to make the integration of dw. But it is velocity changing from initial velocity to final velocity. So u to v I am ready. I am writing as a u to v. Why writing means its velocity changing from initial velocity to final velocity. U to v dw I am writing. Now this is what is here total work done. This is called as total work done. Yeah, this is called as a small work done. This is called as a small work done, that is called as a total work done. Now W is equal to total work done is equal to U to V dW. dW I have written as a M V dV. Right? Now that is a M V dV I have written. Now total work done is equal to, here I am taking common constant, the integration with respect to V. Now U to V V dV. Right. Now u to v dv. You know that in the formula in the integration, x to the power of n dx is equal to x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. Right, this is the formula. Here x integration with respect to dx. Here v integration I am writing. V into dv we required. V into dv, how to find here? V power of how much here? 1. So I am writing here x power of n is there, n plus 1 by n plus 1 getting. V power of 1 is there means V power of 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 is equal to V square by 2. Once again listen, integration x to the power of n dx formula, x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. So here V dV is required, integration V dV is required. Integration V dV means V power of how much here? 1. Means V power of 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1. N is there, x power n is there, n plus 1 by n plus 1. Similarly, V power of 1 is there, V power of 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 is equal to what we are getting here, V square by 2. Means integration of V dV is equal to V square by 2 we are getting here. Now that value substitute in this equation. Now I am removing this one. Now I am writing that one. Here W is equal to, I am written as a, here M into, this is V dV integration is completed, that is V square by 2 we are getting. That is a V square by 2, the limits now written as in here. That is limits is what is here, U to V, these are called as a limits. U to V is called as a limits. Now how to substitute the limits here? Now W is equal to M into, first substitute the upper limit. Say in the place of the V, V substitute here. What we are getting, we are saying V square by 2. In the place of the V, we are substituting the same V, V square by 2. Here lower limit is U is there. So in the place of the V, we substitute the U. Here when substituting the lower limit, in middle, we put the minus. Minus of U square by 2. Once again this are here. When substituting the upper limit as is one V, in the place of the V, I am writing the V, V square by 2. Suppose 2 is there, 2 square by 2. 3 is there, upper limit 3 square by 2. Means in the place of the V, we substitute the upper limit. In between we put the what is here, minus. In the place of the V, we substitute the lower limit. So U square by 2. Now we are getting your work done is equal to, now I am written as a M V square by 2 minus M U square by 2. I am multiplying with M. right, I am multiplying with m here. First to substitute the upper limit, d square by 2, in between put the minus. Next to substitute the limit, lower limit, in the base of the d, I am writing the u square by 2. Multiply with m d square by 2 minus m u square by 2. Now, what is getting here now? Here, listen. Here, this is called as a final kinetic energy. This is called as a initial kinetic energy because this is in the form of W is equal to of m v square minus of m u square. This is final velocity is there, final kinetic energy. This is initial velocity is there, initial kinetic energy. So, work done is equal to final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. This is a final kinetic energy, this is a initial kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy is gives a change in the kinetic energy. This is a proof of the what is here, work energy theorem in case of which force here, variable force. Variable force means the force is changes with the time. Here listen, that point also listen here, constant force means F value is always constant. It cannot change with the time, F is constant. Here variable force means it changes with the time, that's the reason F is equal to ma written. In the place of the A, we have written what is here, dV by dt. Means here, this is changes into the time. When the force is changes into the time, that is called as a variable force. When the force is a constant, that is called as a constant force. Or another example also we can take here. When the force F is equal to 20 Newton, 30 Newton, 40 Newton is here, this is called as a here constant force. Here when the F is equal to like this, 2x square I, plus 3y square j, or we can write here, changes with the time means f is equal to 2t cube I, 3t square j, plus 5t k, like this you can write here. This is called as a variable force, or you can write like this also, f is equal to here 2t cube, this is only one term also you can take here, these are r, this is force also changes with the time, this force also changes with the time. These are called as which forces here? Variable forces. Variable forces means the forces which are changes with the time, that is called as a variable forces. The forces which are constant, that is called as what is here? Constant forces. This is a work energy theorem we are deriving in the case of two cases. One is a for constant force, another one is a variable force. Right? Now work energy theorem statement is what is here, work done by a force on the body is equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the body is called as what is here, work energy theorem statement. Right, okay, thank you.